Joining us from New York, a woman who's actually changing this game dramatically, Emily Gould. She's the editor of the website Gawker.com. Hello, Emily.
Hi, Jimmy.
And you look like a very pleasant woman, tell everyone what you do, what goes on your website.
Well, I think that maybe the issue that you have might be with our Gawker Stalker map. Am I right?
Well, yeah, I think that's... explain what that is exactly.
The Gawker Stalker map tells you where celebrities have been sighted in New York City at any given time, so you can sort of scroll around and see, you know, Jude Law was shopping for condoms at the Duane Reade in Midtown,
People are out and they have their cell phones, they can send a little message to you and say, I just saw Gwyneth Paltrow at the movies, and that way, when Gwyneth Paltrow comes out of the movies, there can be at least a dozen psychopaths waiting for her.
That's actually a popular misconception about the way the Stalker map works.
Oh.
It doesn't really happen in real time. I think that's why George Clooney got so upset, because he thought we were actually enabling
stalking.
She's right.
How much of a delay is there when you say...
Sometimes there's a couple of hours that elapse between when a stalking. It's not actually.
What is
stalking.
The shortest delay that you'll have? I mean, can it be 15 minutes after they see a celebrity?
It can be, but it's rare, really rare.
I've had my clients in 5 minutes.
You've had
delays.
In 5 minutes?
I've had them in a store going, these am I allowed to say that word?
I don't know.
There'll be a time. I will predict that there will come a time when one of his clients is spotted, some psychopath, as you say, does something, and somebody will sue this website and make a fortune for being in the chain and for being foreseeable for putting somebody out there and putting them at risk. I'll venture this far to say that it will be only a matter of time before it does happen.
In your opinion,
celebrities have been
of course.
Stalked and celebrities have been murdered, and it does happen.
There.
And it happens a lot more than we even talk about or is reported.
And this is a way to alert people that might be interested in a particular celebrity. And my problem is you post things that simply aren't true on the site, and you do no checking on your stories whatsoever. I'll give you an example. There was a story about me that popped up on my Google search. It said, Daily Gawker Stalker, when isn't Jimmy Kimmel visibly intoxicated? And there's a story about me being visibly intoxicated. I know it may be funny to you, but I didn't find it that amusing.
Okay.
And in matter of fact, the story that talks about me being drunk, I was coming home from my one-year-old cousin's birthday party with my elderly aunt and uncle and my kids and my cousins, and I may have been loud, but I was far from intoxicated. And you put these things on there. I mean, I know you're an editor. What exactly are you editing from the website?
There's a whole other aspect of our website that doesn't have anything to do with the Stalker map, but what the Stalker map is citizen journalism. People don't read it with the expectation that every word of it will be gospel. Everyone who reads it knows that it isn't checked at all. What they read it for is the immediacy.
And necessarily true.
You get an unfiltered sort of the way that people perceive celebrities in real time that you don't get from any other media, and that's what I think is great
about it. But you also get what is essentially slanderous statements or libelous statements put on your website. I mean, for instance, today I noticed there was something about Kevin Costner. I went on to see what was there today, and it just said how fat Kevin Costner was, and then it had a picture of Jabba the Hutt next to him. Now, I know you sell advertising. I don't know why anybody would buy advertising on a website, but I don't know what the point of something like that is.
There's also a big contradiction. She said citizen journalism. She used the word journalism and then said everybody knows not everything's true. Most journalists at least try for the truth. It's a goal.
I mean, do you read Us Weekly and expect that everything in it is true, or Star?
I get calls from them fact-checking, and I don't from your website.
That's absolutely true. Us Weekly at least has a legal department that vets things.
And our photographers at least are taking photographs of things that are happening, as opposed to... I just want you to think about your life and, weigh your options. And, because I would hate to see you arriving in hell and somebody sending a text message saying, guess who's here? You know what I'm saying?
honestly, I think that there's a shifting definition of what is public and what is private space for everyone, not just celebrities. The internet, blogs, MySpace, no one has the reasonable expectation of being able to walk down the street and not have what they're doing be noticed by someone
anymore.
Well,
that is just a terrible thing, though, isn't it? I mean, just
is it really? I mean, I think it's great that we're not putting people up on a pedestal and worshiping them anymore. I think it's good that people are acknowledging that celebrities are real people.
You're throwing rocks at them, though. I mean, it seems to me that celebrities
kind of protected by piles of money from those rocks?
No. And by the way, not all celebrities are wealthy. I mean, you know, that's a silly and stupid thing to say. You know that. Come on now. Just because people have money means it's okay to say false things about them, to tear them down?
It's not okay to say false things about anyone.
Check your website then. Thank you for talking to us. Anderson Cooper, 360's on at the top of the hour.